In this video, I would like to explain how to analyze data from point load test. First, please watch my video. So this video will show you how we conducted two tests on two different rocks. So that was rock number one and rock number two. And these are the results that we obtained. So for rock number one, we tested a core sample. So it was pretty long core sample. Please also watch that video and see how we select the samples for this test. It's very important. For the second sample, for rock 2, it was more like a disk. So we measured the height, which is D, and we measured W, which is the diameter, and all the values shown here. And when we performed the test, the first rock was pretty hard. So the pressure at failure was 3.2 kilonewtons. And the second rock, well, when you see the video, you will see that the rock was a little bit weathered. So you will see that the force we applied to failure was quite low, 0.694 kilonewtons. So now I'm going to explain how we analyze this data and how we can get this point load strength index, which is shown in this column of the table. So this is the value that we're gonna get. So the first thing, we will need to write down the size of the rocks, and I already did that for the first rock because it was a long core sample. You will see that diameter that we measure here, we just only need to know the diameter of the sample, and we apply load in this perpendicular direction. So in this case, you will see that this DE, which stands for equivalent diameter, it's equal to diameter. So in this case, if D is 51, so DE will be 51. It's very easy. It's probably the simplest case. Okay, for the second case, when we apply load in the axial direction here, as already mentioned, we need to know the height, which is D, and it was 39.4 millimeters. W stands for the diameter, it was 51.6. So in this case, to get this equivalent diameter, we actually need to use this formula. So that's the formula. You see that in this formula we have A. A stands for the area. So what we need to do first, we have D and multiply by W. So we can do it right now. I'm going to show you how it works. So A is equal, D is 51.6 times 39.4 will give us 2033.04. Well, it's going to be square millimeters. And then we're going to calculate this equivalent diameter, which is square root 4 times the area, so that's the value that goes here, and divided by pi, 3.14. So I already did the calculations. It will be about 50.878 millimeters. So, and I'm going to write it here, 50.78. Okay, so load to failure, we already know this is what we get from the test, 3.2 and 0.694 for two different rocks. Then we're going to estimate what we called uncorrected point load strength, and this is the formula. So P comes from the test. You see here we multiply by 1000 because our measurements in millimeters. So that's why we get 1000 here. And this is the diameter, equivalent diameter in the power of 2. And I already did the calculations. I think probably the easiest way is to prepare Excel spreadsheet with these numbers and the formulas. It will be pretty easy. So for the first one, it will be 1.23, and for the second one it's going to be pretty low, 0.268. when you watch the video with the second rock, how we tested it, you will see that it was actually weathered at the bottom. So that's why the strength of this rock was relatively low. And the final one, what we need to do is we are going to normalize it to the diameter of 50 millimeters. That's why here you have 50. So again, this is the formula. So this one is IS come from this column. So in this case, we have D and we divide by 50. And this is in the power of 0.45. As already mentioned before, I already have it in my spreadsheet. And I'm gonna give numbers here, 1.241. So it's slightly increased. This one is also slightly increased, 0.27. So this is what we record and what we report when we talked about point load index strength. The good thing about this point load test, we can easily correlate it to the unconfined compressive strength. So please watch my other video to see how we can correlate this point load strength index to unconfined compressive strength. It's pretty simple. Thanks for watching this video and have a nice day. Bye.